Did I hear you break? I can't quite remember just what guided me this way. Oh, may I stand unshaken amidst the crash of the world. It's the crash of the world. May I stand unshaken amidst the crash of the world. The pines, they often whisper. Whisper, no tongue can tell. He who drinks from the deep water, may he know the depths of the well. May I stand unshaken amidst the crash of the world. Amidst the crash of the world. Oh, traveler, what have you seen? Were there crossroads? Where you been? Where you been? I once was standing tall, now I feel my back against the wall. Stand unshaken amidst the crash of the world. May I stand unshaken amidst the crash of the world. But I could not see. And I don't wonder, as a wayward son, were the horns to be haunted by the swarming gun? Oh, stand unshaken amidst the crash of the world.
Susan!
Dear Uncle Tacitus, I do so hope you enjoyed your vacation. Lucky you, leaving like that. And you always suggested you were too old for travel. I hope you and your cousins enjoyed yourselves. Me and your grandnieces have decided to take a trip of our own, as the place has become so dreary and godforsaken in your absence. We've gone to visit relatives. From my daddy's side, you are not yet acquainted with them, in Lacay, a small village just north of Saint-Denis. It's buggy and muggy, but apparently neither is too bad at this time of year. Please come see us when you can. Yours sincerely, Caroline.
Well, thank you, darling niece Caroline.
Milt keeps sending back every day to search this place.
There quite clearly isn't a gang of outlaws held up here.
Someone is here. Look, those are fresh footprints. Looks like someone might be here right now.
Sure, someone is here. There's always someone everywhere.
Well, let's look around, then. See if we can find something for Mr. Milton.
Mr. Milton? I'd like to find a poisonous snake for him.
That's enough, Mr. Johns. You take Mr. Bunter and search around back.
Mr. Orley, let's head inside. Gentlemen, be careful.
Yep. Arthur! Arthur's here!
Oh, Arthur! Oh, you're alive!
Just about.
Come inside. Come on, it's raining. Hey, everybody, look who's here.
How y'all doing? Hey, old man, wake up.
Hey, Arthur, they got John.
Good to see you.
Yeah, he got arrested.
He ain't hung yet?
Not yet. They moved him to Sisica. He's been working on a chain gang.
Howdy.
Oh, look,
yes, they got John.
Okay.
Hey!
How'd you folks find each other? What happened? Can somebody get me a cup of coffee or something?
It was Mrs. Adler who saved us, Dutch. After the robbery in Saint-Denis, she got us away from the camp before the Pinkertons turned up. Then Mrs. Adler and Mr. Smith drove away the degenerates of her living here.
Mrs. Adler, we... Oh, you!
Yes. Yes.
Thank you.
It's been real hard, Dutch. We've been surviving, but only just. What we gonna do?
Things have been tough. There ain't no doubt about that. Trust me. I am gonna get us out of here. This ain't over.
Ain't none of you folks interested in our adventures?
Guess we're more interested in escaping the hangman on our tail?
Cheerful nymph of the prairie, wasn't you, Abigail?
Oh, sure. My fair heart jumps for joy when I set eyes on you, Micah. We buried Hosea, Dutch. Charles and I stole his body from the law one night and gave him a proper burial. It was real nice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, here you is. Well, I asked everyone I could find, and eventually someone knew, said you fools were out here. Shit. Give me a drink or something.
Get your own damn drink.
In our absence, Mrs. Adler here has been looking after things. Now sit down.
This is Agent Milton with the Pinkerton Detective Agency.
Already?
On behalf of Cornwall Kerosene and Tar, the United States government, and the Commonwealth of West Elizabeth.
Here we go.
We are here to arrest you. Come out with your hands up.
Give them to a count of five, then give them everything. Actually,
let them have it.
Everyone get down!
Asked him!
Where's the phony?
Fine, did you,
Bill? This is real bad.
Stay down, Ollie.
Where's the phony?
Where are we going?
This way. There's a trap door into the other house. We can try to flank them.
Arthur.
Oh, me and Bill and Sadie.
You okay, son?
Sure.
We ain't been back for more than a few days.
What do we do, Dutch?
Clearly, we need to leave. It'll take them some time to regroup. Mr. Pearson, Miss Grimshaw, start packing up. Javier, you and Bill, get out of here. Go scare off any scum still loitering about. We need a couple of days. Now, please, gentlemen.
George. What next, Dutch?
We just need some time. I need some time. Now, we can't go east, because then we'll be in the ocean, so we're gonna have to go north, I guess. I just need somebody to buy me some goddamn time, one of you.
You'll figure it out, boss. You always do.
What are you gonna do about John, Dutch?
John?
He's in jail.
Well, we'll get him. Abigail, just not yet.
There's talk of hanging him.
It's not gonna come to that.
Dutch!
Not now, Mesa. Not now.
I'm begging you to. They're gonna hang him and break my... the boy's heart. Please, do something.
We will. Okay. I'm gonna go figure out how we rescue this bastard.
Now?
Yes, now. Meet me at Doyle's Tavern on Million Avenue.
Okay. My lord, what a goddamn mess. Everything. Not sure what happens next. Whole thing has been hard on all of us. Most of all on Dutch, who seems half crazed by all we gone through.
Yeah.